Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to my class. So today I'm going to discuss on the syllabus, reduced syllabus, been released by the council recently. So we'll discuss on history, ICSE history and civics. We're going to discuss. You can see here, just simply you have to type CISCE and go to publication. Okay, tab on publication. So once you tab over here, you'll get history and civics. So tab it, history and civics. Okay. So you can see here, history and civics and geography. So HCHC, this paper one is for history, and other one is for paper two is for geography. Okay, so let me explain you. Okay, see here, class 10 history. So what is included, what is excluded? So there should not be any confusion, my dear. Our main focus is to understand the syllabus. Okay, so section A, that is civics. In this you will be asked three questions. You will be asked to write three questions. Okay, sorry, you will be given three questions, and from there you have to do any two. Okay, so you can see here, section A, civics, union legislature, union executive and judiciary is there. So from union legislature you have to study about Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, their composition, qualification, membership, elections, okay, term, presiding officer, everything you have to study. Okay, and then in union executive you have to study about the president. Okay, you have to study about the president. Here we have to study about the vice president also. So last year vice president was not asked. Okay, so here they have included vice president. Okay, so for vice president you have to study only about the qualification, what is the qualification required, and the term of the office, that is 5 years. Very, very simple, very short topic. You don't have to study about the functions of the vice president. Okay, then Prime Minister and the Council of Minister, you must study. Last year, Vice President was not there. So this year, President, Vice President and the Prime Minister and the Council of Minister, you have to study in chapter number 2, that is Union Executive. Okay. Then let us move on to chapter 3, that is the Judiciary, Supreme Court. So last year we studied only Supreme Court. In the last session, though exam could not be conducted, okay, so we cannot see what type of questions were asked last year. Okay, so Supreme Court is there, and this time they have included this part. Okay, so this here, let me highlight it. So B and C they have included. Okay, so last year only Supreme Court. So for you, you may say, sir, where is the reduction? They have done the addition. So don't worry, my dear children, wait for some time. If you are lucky enough, then very soon you'll get the further reduced syllabus also. Okay, so High Court and subordinate court you have to study. Okay, union legislature, union executive and judiciary, only two things are added, there is no reduction. Okay, now if you move on to section B, that is Indian history, everything is intact. As you compare the present syllabus last year, nothing has changed. Okay, the first war of independence. So let me tell you one thing, my dear, let me tell you one thing. So here the first change, what we see, you have to study only the causes. Okay, and you have to study only the causes. So which are causes? Political, social, religious, and okay, events however need to be mentioned for continuity is asked. Okay, the part like the results of the first war of independence is not included, as it was not included last year in the further reduced syllabus also. Okay, that's one topic you have to study, the causes. Okay, you have to study only the causes. Okay, then if you move to chapter number 2, that is B, factors leading to the growth of nationalism. So here again I see some reduction. Okay, so factors, growth of nationalism, you have to study about Raja Ram Mohan Roy and Jyotiba Phule, and rest all the factors. Okay, many factors were there, no, economic factors, rediscovery of the India's past, everything is removed. So only two things you have to study from here: social and religious reform movement, how it led to the growth of nationalism. Okay, and a special mention must be made for Raja Ram Mohan Roy and Jyotiba Phule. Okay, and one more, role of press. You have to study about the role of press. Okay, and then Indian National Congress, how Indian National Congress was formed. Okay, the immediate objectives of the Indian National Congress you have to study, and special mention must be made about the two sessions, only two sessions, many sessions, no, so only two sessions you have to study. First one was Bombay session, and second one was Calcutta session, and who was the president? Okay. Now second one, you can see here phases. Indian National Movement. You have to study about the moderates. You have to study about the moderates, like how they struggle, what were their objectives. Okay. And two contributions of Dadabhai Naroji, Surinath Banerjee, and Gopal Krishna Gokhale. Okay. And next one, you have to study about aggressive nationalists. But aggressive nationalists is shifted little bit. Before that, you have to study about partition of Bengal. So in 1905, partition of Bengal took place. So the role of the aggressive nationalists became more and more aggressive during this period. Okay. So here also, you have to study about the objectives of the radicals. Their beliefs, their methods. You have to make a comparison between moderates and extremists, and then you have to study only about Muslim League. So here you can see, yeah. Okay, before that, two contribution of Lal Bal Pal, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal, and Lal Lajpat Rai. Two contributions. Okay, and you can see here, last sentence you see here. So what you have to study? This is a separate chapter, right? It is a separate chapter, Muslim League. So here you have to study only about Muslim League. How Muslim League was formed and the objectives. Okay, three objectives of Muslim League. You don't have to go through the entire chapter on Muslim League. Okay, the next one you can see here, mass movement. So here definitely non-cooperation movement, civil disobedience movement, and the Quit India movement. You have to study, you have to go through it. Okay, this part is important in the history of India. Okay, we have to go through that. And the next one is forward block. That means the role of Subhash Chandra Bose. Okay, role of Subhash Chandra Bose, you have to study. Okay, how was forward block formed, what were the objectives of forward block, and what was the contribution of Subhash Chandra Bose for the freedom, in the freedom struggle. Okay, then next one is independence, partition of India. Okay, so here you can see here, you have to study only about, you can see this chapter is also very very lengthy. If you go through your book, you'll find the chapter very very lengthy, but let me make it clear, my dear. From this chapter, you have to study only about Mountbatten Plan and the Indian Independence Act. So, Indian Independence Act, Mountbatten Plan. Why was Mountbatten sent to India? Okay. And why was Mountbatten Plan accepted by the Congress? That you have to study. And then, Indian Independence Act of 1947, you have to study. Okay, cabinet mission and all, everything is removed. So, here we saw the reduction. Okay. Now let us move on to the next part, that is the world history, contemporary world. So here also so many things are removed. So here we have to study about the causes of the First World War, right? On which topic? Nationalism, imperialism, three topics only: nationalism, imperialism, and division of Europe, and the Sarajevo crisis. Okay, so this was also there as per the further reduced syllabus in the last session. Okay. Then rise of dictatorship. So this chapter also very well. So we see a great number of reduction from section from contemporary world history. Okay, world history has made into a very small chapter for us. Okay, it has been reduced to a great extent. So rise of dictatorship, only the similarities. Fascism, Nazism, only the similarities on the basis of ideologies. Then next one, Second World War causes. Okay, causes you have to study, and within the causes you have to mainly focus on rise of fascism, Nazism, Japanese invasion of China, failure of League of Nations, and invasion of Poland by Hitler. That you have to study. And if you come down, United Nations, a very small chapter again. So here you have to study about the objectives of composition of General Assembly, Security Council, International Court of Three. General Assembly, okay, number one, General Assembly, number two, Security Council, and number three, International Court of Justice. Okay, these three you have to study. So you have to study about four, okay, any four functions of these three. Okay, and another one is also a lengthy chapter. From here, we have to study only about major agencies like UNICEF is there, WHO is there, UNESCO is there, any four functions of UNESCO. UNICEF, WHO, and UNESCO, four functions only you have to study. Okay, so last year non-aligned movement was reduced in the further reduced syllabus, but this time they have included. So I hope you all have understood your syllabus properly. So now on the basis of the reduced syllabus, for the year 2022, start preparing for your board exam. Don't think that there won't be any examination. Let exam be cancelled. Okay, doesn't matter. But you must do your primary duties. You must study properly, timely. Okay, listen to your teachers and focus on your studies so that later on, when exams are conducted, when situation becomes normal, at that time you should not face problem. Okay, so this was from today's class. And for more tutorials on civics and history, my channel is already there. So you can search all the topics one by one. All the topics are explained unit wise, chapter wise, in detail. You can get it from my channel. So hope you'll watch it. So we'll meet in the next class with new tutorials on history and civics. Till then, take care, stay safe. Bye bye.